Stolen cars, a major crime, and you may be an easy target. Thieves who want your car may not have to do anything more than just make a few clicks to get it.
And tonight, WRG's April Thompson shows you the easy way criminals are getting in and what you can do to stop them.
Joshua Harvey loves cars, especially the one he got last year.
When got my Dodge Charger that I wanted to drive for the last few years.
And you'd been enjoying it.
I've been enjoying it, yeah. It was, like I said, souped up, everything had pipes on, everything was fine with it. Ran perfectly fine, everything.
Fine until one early morning last October.
I was just watching TV, getting ready before work, and I heard a noise outside, and I wasn't really sure what it was. And so then I heard, sounds like my car was cranked up. Vroom, just the pipes went up. So I went and grabbed my keys, and I went to, you know, went outside to see what was going on, and my car was gone.
He jumped in his wife's car and tried to go after the car thieves.
I just took off down the street. It's like exactly, my car has really loud pipes, so I heard the pipes go off, and I just took off down the street.
Joshua Harvey never caught up with those thieves. Neither did police, who he says were already in the area. But get this. Harvey says his car was locked.
I'm looking for my key. I'm like, I have my keys. So how did they get in the car? There's no glass broken or anything. But that's what the police told me, that they probably had a programmer and they were able to just drop off with it.
And he says it happened quickly, in a couple of minutes.
Well, they were assuming that the car, what they end up doing is taking a programmer or an app, and they just get the VIN number from the programmer app. And I guess from that point, they're just able to crank the car up and drive off.
Thieves using technology more, especially as more cars are now connected to the internet and even have remote locking and starting features that can be activated via a key fob or an app.
We're in a new era today.
Benny Cobb owns Eagle Eye Security and is a retired Shelby County Sheriff's Captain. He says whenever you don't use a physical key, you open yourself up for hacking.
But with the era of electronic, the ability to defeat the lock without breaking the window, or setting off the alarm with these smartphones and these other devices, it's increasing. It's going to continue to increase until either the auto manufacturers or the Congress come up with something that can prevent the locks from being defeated.
It's like, what can you do? It's pretty much, you could be out with your family somewhere and someone just walks up to your car and takes your car and drive off. So it's one of those things, like, there's nothing really you can do about it.
But there are things you can do. Steering wheel locks will slow a thief down, and using the car's inside door lock instead of a fob to lock your vehicle. Anything to make it harder for thieves to steal your ride.
They have these detection device where you can stop your key fob from being detected by putting it in an electronic prevented pouch. Or even something that's ridiculous, but it's work, is putting your key fob in the refrigerator when you're in the house. That would stop your signal from being broadcast or stop somebody from picking up your security code.
Police did eventually find Harvey's car a few days after it was stolen.
Front end damage on it. Looks like rear damage. All the airbags were popped out of the car. Looks like they had been joyriding in the car. There were drinks in it, shoes in it. They took all of my things out.
April Thompson, WREG News Channel 3.
Trying to stay a step ahead of the thieves, and many car manufacturers have also started using rolling codes that become inactive once they are used to unlock your car. That makes it harder for thieves to intercept and use the code.